Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So today I have a video for my alopecia sufferers out there. You guys have been asking for another hairstyling tips video, so I finally am doing one right now. I took so long to do this because I wanted to try a lot of different tools out there and see what worked best, and so that I could bring you guys the best tips possible. In case you guys are wondering why I have all this crazy glitter on my face, this is for my New Year's makeup tutorial. I will link it down below for you guys, as well as all the things that we talk about in this video like I normally do. So this video is for those of you that are experiencing regrowth in your hair. You guys can tell from my hair that I have a bunch of hairs that have been growing in over the past, I would say since January, so almost a year now, and they've gotten down to about there. Which is really amazing, but then I also have some shorter hairs as well. So this is for those of you that are going through regrowth, and then I'm gonna break this down into two different parts. So the first part is gonna be for people that are experiencing regrowth, but then are also having hair that is shedding still at the same time, which is possible. And the other part is gonna be for those of you that have regrowth and no shedding, and then we're gonna talk about like shorter hairs that are growing in versus longer hairs and what to do with that. So let's get into this video. Before we do, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and give me a thumbs up if you like it. Okay, so for those of you that are experiencing regrowth, but you're still having hairs that are shedding from your head, we all know what it feels like to not want to touch your hair or not do too much to it because you don't want to encourage any hairs to be lost at all. But at the same time, we all wanna have nice hair. We all wanna experience good hair days because we all know when you go through alopecia, it really does take a toll on your self-esteem. So one of the things that I would recommend investing in is a waving wand. Waving wands are fantastic because they don't have clamps. So if you've seen my other video on hairstyling tips for alopecia, you guys already seen me talk about how you can take your hair and wrap it around and it's going to give you really nice waves and curls and stuff like that in your hair. But that's not what we're going to talk about today. What we're going to talk about is how to make your hair look really smooth and unified. A lot of us know that when we wake up in the morning with regrowth, your hair can be going in 5 million different directions. I know that I get these hairs that are a little bit shorter tend to be curled in. The layers that are underneath will be poking out in between my longer hairs. So it can be a little bit of a mess. And also for those of you that have a bit of a wave to your hair, it can kind of look a little messy and frizzy and stuff. So what you want to do with the waving wand is you want to smooth out your hair. You're going to really lightly hold your hair, and you're just gonna take a hot waving wand, and it's the same idea as when you're ironing clothes. You're just running the waving wand along your hair, and what that's gonna do is it's gonna smooth everything out. It's gonna make the hairs sit a little bit more flat, and it's gonna make it blend into your existing hairs a little bit better. So a few things to note is you definitely want to make sure that you avoid touching your scalp at all costs. Trust me, you know, no matter what you're doing or how experienced you are, accidents happen, as we can see right over here. That is from this. But just basically what you wanna do is there's a glove that comes with it that you can use with most waving wands, and just hold it out. I find if you hold it out perpendicular to your head, that helps a lot. And then just lightly just run it over, and just like with short motions, and the risk of damage will be a lot less. So that's one thing that you wanna do, and you can go section by section. So do one section, flip it over, and then do another section, and you'll get probably more smooth hair than you've gotten since the alopecia started. So hopefully that helps you guys. And then afterwards you can always curl it, but I like to smooth it first just so it gets all going in the same direction and sort of smoothed out and flattened out at the top, and then throw some curls into it. Okay, now on to my alopecia sufferers that are experiencing regrowth without shedding. First of all, hooray for you, that's awesome. I'm so excited for you guys. I know what it feels like. I've been there, lost 70% of my hair. In case you guys don't know about it, I will link my alopecia story below for you. But like I mentioned earlier, I totally know what it feels like to wake up and things are going in completely different directions, or you wash your hair and it's all still going, even if you were to wash your hair with a round brush, it still will end up going in different directions. I know for myself, I would style it with a round brush and it would look great and stuff like that the first day, and then the second day after I would sleep on it, there'd be these hairs underneath that would be poking through and going in all these different directions. My hair would look like this giant big old mess. And the only thing that saved me was this little guy right over here. So this is a mini flat iron. So what that means is that it's really tiny compared to regular flat irons. So it's perfect for those of you that have regrowth where your hair is only maybe a couple of inches long. And this is maybe about 4 to 5 inches long. So this is a little bit longer than what I would suggest it'd be really good for. I'm talking about hairs that are a little bit shorter like this, what you would want to do is just like a regular flat iron, you would take your hair and then you would just flat iron it through, and it's going to smooth it out. It's going to make it a lot more straight, and then when it's straight and the rest of the hair is straight as well, it blends in a lot better than if it were to just be styled with a round brush, because a round brush is going to curl it and it's not going to give the same tension as it would to the longer hairs. So when you're pulling your round brush through, it's going to curl this part because the brush is round, and it's going to flatten this and then only curl the end in. So that's why you definitely want to use a flat iron, and these are fantastic for when it comes to shorter hairs, because then you can get right in there and you don't really have to worry about hurting or burning your scalp or anything like that because it's so tiny. So if you guys have not heard of these before, these are fantastic mini flat irons. I'm going to link it down below for you guys. This one is from Drybar. They make fantastic products. All right, for those of you that are in my situation where you have regrowth, no shedding, and your hairs are now about 4 to 5 inches long at least, you guys can use a full size flat iron. So this is the GHD Platinum. This one is fantastic. You can use a lot, there's a lot of really great flat irons out there. I just wanted to make sure that I had something that had slip on the blade, because even though my hair is not falling out anymore, you have that paranoia inside, and you want to keep every single hair that you have on your head intact because you went through all that trauma of losing it in the first place. So whatever it is that you have on your head, you want to keep it there. So that's why you want to find something that has a nice slip to it. The GHDs are really great for that. The newer generation ones are fantastic, as well as the Chi. Chi is fantastic as well. And so basically what you want to do is you just want to go section by section. What I do is I don't go too close to the scalp because I don't want to flatten my hair. I still like a little bit of volume. My hair is about like a fine to medium texture. And if I just start flat ironing from the root, it's going to look like it's like stuck to my head. So I'll start maybe a couple of inches down, and then I'll just run it through the short hairs mixed in with the longer hairs, so that it blends them together. And I'll just take section by section, and I'll also get the hairs underneath, because the thing is, when you think about your hair regrowing, it's not just growing in this area, it's growing all over. So you have all these hairs that are even down like throughout here that are growing back in, and they're different lengths. So you can even do like section by section if you want to get really technical, like if you're going to a party or whatever and you want to make sure that your hair looks fantastic, you can do like proper section by section, and then just make sure you flat iron it all together. And then once you have all of your hairs going in the same cohesive direction, then you can go ahead and style it however you want. You can throw some curls in it, like I was mentioning before. And also too, I find when you flat iron your hair that it kind of helps it last a little bit longer. Like over a few sleeps, it definitely lasts a lot longer than if you were to just use a round brush and blow dry your hair. And also too, what I'll do is if after 2 or 3 nights of sleeping on it, it starts to get a little curled in and stuff like that, I'll just touch up those parts and make sure that they're straight again so that they all go in the same direction as the rest of my hairs. So those are just some tips that I wanted to share with you guys that I've tried that worked for me. And if you guys have any other questions or any other alopecia videos you guys want to watch, just let me know in the comments below. And I hope this helped you guys. If you guys are going through alopecia and you need to talk to somebody, just don't hesitate to reach out to me. And there's also a lot of forums online and stuff like that with people that you can talk to and share your story and learn different tips and tricks from, and things that they've tried that have worked for them. It's definitely a tough journey, but there's a really supportive community out there of people. So don't hesitate to reach out, and I hope you guys are doing well, and I'll see you guys next week with another video.